has been the journey so far? Death traveled on and still found corruption. The light and the Helmguard both lost. But Arafel's wisdom shone bright in the darkness and cleared the way forward for all.
Hello and welcome back to Darksiders 2. It's been about a week since I last played, but luckily I did do a little practice run this morning, so I know what I'm doing. As a matter of fact, we're actually getting close to the end. Yeah, so the end of the game. Well, it's the main end of the main story. We still have 3 pieces of DLC to do. Once we're done with the main story, but we should get the main story done in this recording session. So exciting! Exciting, isn't it? Okay, there's a B button over its head. Why aren't you using it? I'm pushing the B button. Why is it working? There we go. Maybe because his health wasn't low enough. Or something. Last night, which you guys saw the videos this morning, because I uploaded them this morning, is that I finished out the Lord of the Rings War in the North game. That's that game. So, it's exciting. And today, tonight, which you guys will see this tomorrow, we'll finish off the main story for Darksiders 2. And then next week, I'll do the 3 pieces of DLC that are attached to the game. I say attached because they don't actually go with the game. I had to buy them separately, but whatever. And there's a statue of, what's his name? The one that sets us to do all this in the first place.
Thank you.
All right, we got ourselves a puzzle here. Yay, we love puzzles. This one is really simple, really. Open this door. Yeah, this one's actually quite simple. What you simply want to do is you want to equip your Void Walker and then Soul Split. And we want to lower this one. Down. Put the portal there, then you let it go. And now you want to lower this one. Easy as pie. No, I thought I saw something. Nope, there you go. For an angel, you sure do fall down into a pit easily. I thought you could fly. Isn't that what you got wings for? Alright. Get over here. Ah, dude, get out of that stuff. Get out of stuff. I wanted to kill that corrupted spirit, not jump into the black stuff. Yeah. Alright. Then we have that thing unlocked. Put a portal there. Unfortunately, we had to go all the way around that place we were before. But not fall into a hole. There, death. Not fall into a hole. I was trying to fall onto the land underneath me. But he fell in the hole instead. Yay. The water is purified. Now we can go into here. Anything interesting in here, or? Oh, there's a gnome in here. Well, apparently I found a gnome. Okay. I swear that creature is teasing me. Enough with your teaser. Come face me like a man. Alright, that's two water hills now. Purified. You need to stop with your teasing and just face me. Face me, you coward! There's nothing in that water, but more dead. Oh. Dead angels. Oh, I wouldn't be using this thing a lot. Missile little section. No, he just keeps teleporting away. Oh, get tired of teleporting, huh? Get tired of teasing me, huh? Decided to face off with me finally. Well, there's more than one! I thought it was just the one! But no, turns out there's more than one. A bunch of chairs. Guessing this was some kind of council room. It was. Now it's just a broken furniture. What we have here, ladies and gentlemen, is a bit of a puzzle. During my practice run, I was a little confused by it at first because it's been a long time since I've done it, so I couldn't remember how to do it at first. But this is actually quite simple, really. Alright, what you want to do here is you want to stone split. Open up this there. And drag this thing out. Like what we did in the City of the Dead. This is a part where I got a little confused and didn't know what I was doing at first. Alright. Put her there. to the portal there. There we go. Oops. That's the wrong button. If I do it like this, I can get this chest that's over here. That's not the reason why I put that portal there, of course. So making sure that's looking at the right thing. Alright, now I got the portal set, I have to do this again. Bit tedious, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Once you have that done and dusted, you have the two portals lined up. You light that up and then release it, and it lights that one up. Put a portal here, put a portal there, and bingo! The third bit of water is now purified. Apparently that's too high for him to jump. This death can't double jump in this game. Which I think is kind of unfair. It's like I explained before at the beginning of the game, it would have made him 10 times better than War if he could double jump. But alas, he cannot. I was about to say, any more little souls that need a smashing? No, apparently not. Ooh, is that underwater cave here? Or is it just... Oh no, it's just what's under the... What's under the bridge? This is in case you like fall in the water. My bad. I thought I was gonna find a secret. All right, before I head off to do the boss battle with the scholar, let's check in my inventories. I picked up quite a few stags. And before I head off to meet with the scholar, I'm going to go pick up my some potions. Well, my health potions are all full, but I need wrath potions.
There is more I could send. The money.
I just saw a boatman kind of sitting behind him, so I have to make sure I pick that up. Bloods.
The money is. Battle will. It will suck. When you're ready, it's yours.
Alright, do you have anything I could use before I get out of? Nope. No. 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 No, no, no. Oh, hold on. I don't like the fact that it takes away the health boost. I like those health boosts. No? Alright, let's go back and face off with the scholar. The scholar boss battle is actually really, really easy. It's really simple. I mean, if you don't know what you're doing, it's gonna be hard, but I happen to know what I'm doing, so. Now, the other thing you need equipped is your Voidwalker. That's what you need equipped. And why it teleported me here and not in front of the door where we meet up with the scholar, I do not know.